So today we are going to start with letter for placing an order. Okay, so open up your notebooks, fair notebooks where you have to do, because we are going to note down the format also. Let's start. Yes, we have to do letter for placing an order. So you know that what are letters for business, what are formal letters? Formal letters, they are mainly fall in the category which we have to write some authorities or to some, you can say, companies in order to place an order, in order to make an inquiry, in order to complain, or in order to cancel an order. So now, today we are going in the category of these formal letters, business letters actually these are. Now we are going to do letter for placing an order. So now, for letter for placing an order, so first of all, you have to write down sender's address. Note down in your notebooks, format. I will write down little bit on that side, that is right hand side, so that it is completely visible to you. Sender's address. Then you have to leave line. You will write down date. Then receiver's address. So if receiver's address, it varies. It depends to whom you are going to write down this letter. For example, if you have to write down to some, you can say authority, or to some, you can say to some wholesale retailer. So then you will write down the manager, messes and senders, name of the company, and then ultimately name of the city. Or you can also write down the proprietor, means who is the owner of that shop, and next afterwards name of the shop and then city. Mainly in three lines you have to write down the receiver's address. Remember, in case of receiver's address, no comma, no full stop is used. Then write down subject. So what will be the subject here? What will be the subject here? Let me admit the students who have entered late. Yes, Dia, what will be the subject here?
To place an order about for.
Yes, to place an order for. Okay. To place an order for, you can write down in this manner. So, and it depends that what order you are going to place here, you have to write it here. Now, next afterwards, we have to start with para one. Now, para one, which I always call as introductory para. How you start? Can anybody tell me? Can anybody tell how you start? Yes, Dia.
This is in reference to the advertisement given in the newspaper.
No. We won't use here advertisement because we haven't seen any advertisement. Okay. And advertisement, it is may not mainly like that we used to write on when we have to write on for inquiries. Any other suggestion?
We have been long-term partners for a period of time, and I trust your work, so therefore I would like to place
Yes,
an order.
means whatever the lines you are thinking is absolutely right. So how you have to start? You will start first of all telling who you are and why you are writing a letter. Who you are and why you are writing a letter. So now in this case, when you have to write down who you are and why you are writing a letter, then what you will, how you will start, you will speak, for example, in this manner: as you are a renowned name in the field of books, whatever you want to write down, as you are a renowned name in the field of this, and I, as an owner or as a librarian, it depends, or I dash want to place an order for dash, why you are going to place an order, as give the reason that why you are going to place an order. For example, you are going to start a new outlet, or you require books, you require lab material, you require whatever the reason is. Okay, so there are number of orders that you can write down, and according to the requirement you have to write down that whichever thing you want to write. So you have to be creative enough in order to write down who you are, why you are writing a letter, and what is the reason of writing this letter, and why you are going to place an order. It's clear? So I once again repeat, as you are a renowned name, I will write down on the board for your convenience. So in continuity to this, you will write down, as you are a renowned name in the field of dash, and I as dash want to place an order for dash. Here you will write down items, whichever items you want to place an order for. And I as dash want to place an order for dash as. Now here you will give the reason of placing an order. What you will write down, you will give a reason for placing an order. It's clear? Here you will write down the reason for placing an order. Next, when you have to place an order, you have to tell the concerned person that whichever things you require. So ultimately there must be some systematic way how you will tell the person. So in second para, that is para 2, which I always call as main para, here you will place the order. So you will write down the order is as, follows. Now for that you have to make a table, right? Serial number, name of the item you want to place an order, then model. For example, if you want to place an order for electronic equipment, so there in case you must have seen the brochure where the model is given. So you have to write down about the model. This can only be an imaginary one. For example, SF001. It can be an imaginary one. I don't expect you to write down the actual models. This depends upon the situation. For example, if you are going to write down for books, would you write down model? No. Then this column will be omitted. Then afterwards, quantity. How much you require? You will mention about quantity, that how much you require, and for example, you want 1 or you want 2 or you want 10 in number, whatever the number is, you have to mention there. So it means that your letter for placing an order, it must be a clear one and it must include all the important information so that the person to whom you are going to place an order, he will definitely get to know that what you are going to ask about. I hope that it is clear. Now, next afterwards, make a table. Here your serial number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 can be there. Next after that, we have to proceed towards paragraph number 3. Now, para 3, in para 3, what you will discuss? You will discuss about terms and conditions. Now, many things you have to make clear at the starting so that there will be facilitation of healthy business between you and the person to whom you are placing an order. Now you have to write down. So any ideas, which conditions you have to write down here? Which conditions you would like to place? Okay, let me ask. Okay, Dia, first of all you, then Ramneek you. Yes, Dia.
My mode of payment, cash on delivery and or okay. Net banking.
Right. I will note down the point here on the side. I will note down here, because if I note down at the main, you will write down in exams in the same manner. Mode of payment. Then, Ramneek, unmute yourself. Yes, Ramneek.
Yes, ma'am. If we are placing an order for something, then we can write about that. If, example, if we are placing the order for books, then we can say that the books should be in good quality.
Okay. Right, for books. Okay, definitely. Okay, today we will do for books. Books in good quality. If I talk about general, then what you have to write down? So here, first of all, for terms and conditions, what you will write down? First of all, you will ask about that the delivery, when the delivery should be. So, I expect the delivery within 15 days or within 1 month. Within 1 month of this letter. Then, if any damage, if during transportation any damage is caused, then who will bear the cost? This you also have to mention. So, you will mention any damage caused during transit. Any damage caused during transit, then if during transportation any damage is caused, then who will bear the cost? Naturally, the person who is sending the items. Transit will be returned at your own cost. then you will also definitely ask about the quality. So what you will write down, you will add on the point that ensure the quality. Okay, ensure quality. When? Before packaging. And next, if you are placing an order, naturally it is but obvious that you will not only place an order and the person will rely upon you. Yes, he has placed an order and I will send the things. No, you have to send something or you have to send some money in advance. So for this reason, what you have to make, you have to mention that you are enclosing with it a draft. Or if you are just placing an order, then ask about, you can also ask about here that what will be the mode of payment. Ask about mode of payment. If you already know mode of payment, it depends. Okay, then you can write down, please find enclosed a draft of rupees dash drawn at, no, mention the date also, dated dash drawn at dash bank. Okay, with any bank it can be. Please find and close a draft of rupees dash, dated dash, drawn at dash bank as advance. No, right? Now, suppose you have placed an order and the other person is taking so long time in order to deliver your goods, and ultimately you are suffering. Sometimes you have some urgent work. Sometimes you have some urgent, you can say, celebration for which you need. So for that case, you have to make it clear here only. In case of late delivery, the order will be considered as cancelled. Add on this point also. In case of late delivery, the order can be considered as cancelled. So finally, after writing all this, the last paragraph that is only of one line, what you have to write down, then you have to write down here concluding para means your language should be sugar coated in whatever you want to write down. You should not be harsh. Okay, and ultimately, as you are placing an order, it means that you are facilitating for a healthy business or a happy business. So for that, you will write down looking forward for and for prompt delivery, or looking forward for a healthy business. Okay, so anything can be written, and you know that in case of these formal letters, what we are going to write at the end, we always write at the end in the complimentary clause as yours truly. Yours truly will be included. So I hope that this is clear now. Now, write down the question for it. Write down the question for placing an order. Write down, as librarian, model secondary school, as librarian, model secondary school, New Delhi, as librarian, model secondary school, New Delhi, write a letter to Messrs and Sanders. See how you will write down? Messrs and Sanders. Sohan Lal and Brothers. Sohan Lal and Brothers. Booksellers. Sohan Lal and Brothers. Booksellers. Agra. Agra. Placing an order for books. To be supplied immediately. To be supplied immediately. Now, coming up to the letter. First of all, now give your ideas. First of all, write down sender's address in your notebooks. Sender's address, which will be in three lines. House number. Area or colony, then city. So write down sender's address. I hope it is written. Leave line. Write down date. Leave line. Write down date. Then, what will be the receiver's address? Now speak out. What will be the receiver's address? Yes. Speak out.
The retailer, Sohan Lal and Books, Brothers Booksellers, Agra.
Agra.
Yes. So, ultimately, you will write down simply... no need to write down retailer. Who is retailer? Who is selling books small in amount? Wholesaler means the person who is selling in bulk. So here you know you don't need to mention here retailer. You will simply start Messrs and Sanders, Sohan Lal and Brothers. And next line, Agra. So, if you are writing to a manager, you can also write down at the top. The manager, Messrs and Sanders, Sohan Lal and Brothers, and then your, and then city. Both can be written. Next, afterwards, write down subject. Subject. Yes, what will be the subject?
To place an order for books.
Yes, to place an order for books. Right. Next. Afterwards, how you will start? Para 1, that is the introductory para. Speak out.
As you are a renowned name in the field of books, and I as a librarian of Model Secondary School want to place an order for books.
Okay, so here you can also write down, suppose you have written as you are a renowned name in the field of booksellers and we have been in business with you since a long time. Okay, so just show your strength and bond which you are sharing with the person, with the wholesaler to whom you are placing an order so that he can be reminded of your good relations. Okay, so you can also write down in this manner, as you are a renowned name in the field of booksellers and we have developed a strengthened bond of business for many years. Or simply write down, because you are writing as a librarian, as you are a renowned name in the field of booksellers and I as a librarian of ... school wanted to place an order for books in bulk, because you don't need books small in number like 3, 4, 5. You need books in bulk. Why? Because we are extending a section of our library or of our school library. that you are going to extend a section of your school library. It is just because of this reason that you are writing why you need books. I told in the very first paragraph that you have to mention the reason why you are going to write down this letter. Next. Para 2, place an order. The order is as follows. Make the table. Okay, this you will do afterwards. You will make the table, and in the table you will mention the number of books. Okay, for example, first of all, here, yes. Here, in case of books, when you make the table for books, what you will add? Model won't be included, but you can mention the name of publishers, right? Or name of publication house. For example, you want a series of or all volumes of Tales of Shakespeare, right? So then you can mention which publisher you want. You want for V Connect, you want for RK Publishers, whatever. This can also be an imaginary one, right? And now, then in quantity, one copy each. It means you need one copy each or two copies of each book. You will clearly mention. Now, it is not necessary that you will only mention books of, you can say English. You can also mention about Hindi. So for English, you will make one heading, give the heading English, then mention the name of the books, then publishers, and then quantity. And if you are going to mention for Hindi, next 5 to 6 books, then ultimately make mention for Hindi, and then name of the books, then publisher, and then quantity. So in this manner, you will write down. Now, coming up to para 3, that is the terms and conditions. For terms and conditions, again, the same thing. I expect the delivery within 15 days. 15 days.
Of this order.
15 days of the month. Of this letter. And any damage caused during transit will be returned at your own cost. Ensure the quality of books before packaging, and make sure that the edition should be the latest one. This must be included. It means you have to invent some new details, some necessary details according to the requirement of the subject, right? So ensure the quality of the books, that the pages should not be yellowish, and the edition should be the latest one. Then kindly let us know the mode of payment if you want to write so, or you can write down, please find and close a draft of rupees dash, because you are already in business with this. So you can omit this line, and you can write down drawn at dash bank as advance and looking forward for prompt delivery. Last concluding para. Okay, looking forward for prompt delivery. And at the end, complimentary close, yours truly, and then your name. And with this, letter for placing an order has been done. And tomorrow we will do one more example. And along with that, you will be ready with your grammar books. We will do the practice of editing and omissions. So I hope that it is fine with you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Right? Yes, so write this letter in your FAIR notebooks. And today, for today, it is done.